Hello, Lime Warriors. This is Claire. I haven't been on for a while, and mainly because I didn't know how to really follow up from the last entry. I don't feel any better. Just so you know, I'm still in the same emotional state. So I didn't really know what to say. So an article came out in Psychology Today, which really got me going, and really helped me kind of understand more about what I'm going through. And I'd forgotten all about it. I'd read it before. It's a book by Pamela Weintraub called Cure Unknown, and all about her experience with Lyme disease. She's an editor for Discover magazine. Anyway, I'm going to read this article. It may take a while, but I know that it might reach more of you if I read it than if you try to read it yourselves, because I don't think you actually read it. I'm going to read it to you. The first time I met a group of severely disabled Lyme patients, I spent hours listening to their stories, some of them heartbreaking, and mourned with them, their lives of frustration and pain. A month later, when I met the same patients again, several could not recall me. At first I was insulted. Had I been that forgettable? My empathy that banal? Then I realized something I had never fully grasped, despite my research. Despite my own Lyme disease. Unless you have personally encountered the shadow land of the most afflicted of patients, a world eclipsed by strange lapses of memory, broken speech, and the struggle to follow the simplest train of thought, you cannot begin to fathom the dense, disabling fog that may accompany this disease. To this day, popular perception holds that Lyme disease is an affliction of knees characterized by swollen joints and an inability to serve in tennis or descend a flight of stairs. Musculoskeletal symptoms can be a hallmark of Lyme disease, but the early rheumatologists had recognized just one part of the elephant. It would take more time and a broad array of specialists for the widening picture to emerge.